The next one that I'll show that we've been using for quite a bit is the LiveScribe Smartpen. With some of the marketing that they did, she was showing quite a bit about this, the Smartpen. So I'll touch on this for just a little while. This is a pen that has a digital display. Oh, I haven't set the time yet. This is a newer pen. It has 2 gigs of memory. And so this pen is able to record audio. The paper that it uses is specific to this type of pen. And I don't know if it will focus. Probably not. There's tiny, minuscule little dots on this page. So you have to use this page with these pens. At the bottom of this pen, there's a camera that's detecting each little dot on that page. So it knows in this book what every centimeter of every page is in this whole book. And as what I can do is, let me flip over to this page. There's the menu here at the bottom. Very, very basic. If I hit record, it starts showing that I'm recording there. And it's recording the audio just through a microphone right here. And here it has a speaker. I'll show you that just at the very end there. So for individuals that need to remember things that is happening while they are writing, they can write on the page and take notes in a class or maybe at a doctor's appointment. I'll show you in just a minute how this is really great. But when I was in college, I had these little mini micro cassette recorders, right? And I'd take those to class and I'd have 60 minutes of the recording. And maybe the teacher at the time said, there's gonna be a test on microorganisms. And so I would take my notes as fast as I could. Everything would be recorded. And then I would go home. Oh yeah, they told me on the test that there was something on microorganisms. And so I'd take about 15, 20 minutes trying to find that spot on that tape. So that's typically how I studied when I was at school. And this has just kind of revolutionized that idea of note taking. So like I said, if somebody's in a college course or maybe they're at a doctor's appointment where the doctor's telling them some things. They can jot down some notes here and there. Every time they write on the page, no matter what it is, it's putting a little bookmark in time at that point so that you can then go back and listen to that area. So if I hit stop here, I've recorded for 1 minute and 34 seconds, as you can see on there. And so on this page, I can go back at any point. One of the last things I wrote down while I was recording was the star. I can click on that. Or if I wanted to know about my micro cassette recorder. Or back to the test on microorganisms. Oh, maybe I couldn't hear
that. So I would take my notes as fast as I could. Everything would be recorded.
Let me try that again and hold that up.
Mini micro cassette recorders, right? And I take those to class and they read on the page, no matter what it is.
So really, really cool. I can go back, if I had a note that I took a year ago, I can go back and click on that.
Then we skip on over to pets. No pets, fish, got a cat.
Let's see what they were saying about food.
Saying, hey, you know, what's everyone's favorite food? Everyone likes Cafe Rio. Then we skip on over to pet.
So you can see how this could be really, really useful. Any page in this book, and it can remember up to 4 books. You can go back, just click on anything that was being said at that time, and just take you back to that moment. Great for studying, great for anything where maybe an individual that's had a brain injury needs to write down things and then go back later and listen to it because they have just had some processing or maybe some memory issues with that. So a really, really great pen. These are about $110 on Amazon. That's where we typically find them the cheapest. This one is the Echo Smartpen. Echo, which we like because it uses just the pen and the paper. They do have a couple different pens out there. One is called the LiveScribe Sky Pen that uploads everything to the cloud in Evernote. This can, you can connect a headset to it So you can listen to things just through the headphones there. And then you need to charge it here occasionally, of course. But as what this will do is drop everything that's written on this page into a free program that you can download from their website. And it stores all the audio and written text on there. So my handwriting of test, which is awful here, would show up on my computer. I could use my mouse to go to the screen and click it, and it would play back that audio from the backup version of that. Another great feature that it has is there's a search bar, and even with this written text, I could go in and write or type in test, and it would search through, if this book was completely full, every area that I had written the word test. Even with my pretty poor writing, it does a pretty good job. Somebody that writes this neatly, it could find anything. So you may be able to go back on the computer and you wanted to search for things in a college course on, I don't know, anything in the solar system, anything specific, type that in there and find every page that's related to that, click on it, and then it would read that back to you so that you could do some great studying at that point. So that's the LiveScribe Smartpen, really, really great. As I said, there's a SkyPen that we don't like quite as much because it won't back up to the computer, stores everything in the cloud. And then they have a LiveScribe pen that works with the iPad. It's Bluetooth enabled, and so when I'm writing on this page, it's sending my writing to the iPad. So whatever I would write on that page, 3x4, it would send that to the iPad, and the iPad's actually recording that. Some other great features. Let's see if I can actually get it to work.
Main menu.
If I write CALC, should turn that into a calculator. 984 times 68, just pulling numbers out. 66,912. It's got a lot of little fun features like that. There's also a scientific calculator in the front that you can see there. But calling it a smart pen is obviously that that it can figure out some of my math that I've just written down on the page there. It does really, really great. And there's some other apps that you can install that are really interesting. And then just some fun games. Yeah, question?
Yeah, we do have a question, and it's mine. What basic abilities should a student have to be able to use the smart pen effectively?
Oh, great, great question. So we try to implement this with a lot of high school students that need some assistance with writing and note-taking. We have some pretty good success with seniors and juniors. A lot of it has to do with the motivation, right? Some of the high school students, in fact, I've got two high school students and my own kids, and I've given them this pen and told them how cool it would be, and they just don't use it. There's no motivation in it for them. We see kind of limited success with individuals in high school, and then as the grades lower, we have more limited success with them, just because, and it's a great question. I think it just comes down to that motivation, even when they see how great it can be. Just sometimes clicking record, they just don't remember. We see a lot of really great success in college. In fact, any of the college students that are out there, if you wanted to check in with the Disability Resource Centers, they have these that people can check out and use throughout the semester. They used to provide note takers where somebody would go in and take notes for an individual. But college students are just loving this. I think they get it. They're a bunch more motivated. As far as what abilities you might need to have, we go in and we've met with people that have some real severe spelling problems. And as you can see, like here for the microorganisms, you don't need to spell out the word, and that's what we try to teach them, is that maybe there's something that's being said in class and they just put a heart or a star so that they can go back and they're at least putting that moment in time where they can go back and listen to things that meant a lot to them at that time.
We have another question. At what distance can the pen pick up a voice such as a professor in front of a classroom?
Yeah, another great question. We teach the individual using it that they should sit as close as possible. Within the first couple rows, I think it does a really great job. It can get a little bit noisy. I was showing this to an individual at a gym to see if it would work for him. Let's hear what it was. There's a lot of background noise here.
So you could write something real quick.
Let me do the phone number that I just made up.
Your phone number is 801-555-62. Say they're going too fast for
you. So it does a pretty good job. There may be a lot of background noise that may make it more difficult to hear, but usually you can capture what the professor was saying. If somebody sits within the first couple rows, they'll easily be able to hear. It does a pretty good job capturing it just through that little microphone there. So if you're further back in the class, and it depends on the class, if they're using the microphone, yeah, no problem if it's being transmitted through speakers. But it does a really, really great job. And pretty cost effective, I think. $100 for this. These books, for the college size books, for four of them, for $20 or so. This is a 2 gig pen that can record upwards of 400 hours of audio.